Hey guys, what's up? It's a King here. Today, I'm doing another series, Mafia 2 Definitive Edition. And before we get started, I want you guys to hit the subscribe button, hit that like button, share this video, all your friends so you guys enjoy this video more in the future. Anyways, let's get right into it. I know it's been a while since I've, recorded a video. I'll get into it later in the video, or maybe not, I don't know. But yeah. Anyways, this is Mafia 2. I've wanted to do this for a long time, and oh, here we go.
My name is Vito Scaletta. I was born in Sicily in 1925. That little guy's me. I'm standing there with my parents and my sister Francesca in front of our old house. I don't really remember too much about the old country, except that we were pretty hard up. And then one day my father decided it was time to move away. From Sicily, across the ocean, to start a new life in America.
In this cutscene, we see a lot of characters that will come to meet later in the game. I don't want to spoil it.
Never in my life had I seen anything as fantastic as Empire Bay. It was beautiful. On the other hand, I'd never seen anything filthier, more disgusting than our new shithole of an apartment.
But yeah, a lot of characters we'll meet later in the game.
The American Dream. It was more like a nightmare. My father started working at the port for the guy who arranged our immigration. It was backbreaking work, and what little money he made mostly went towards booze. Eventually, my parents sent me to school. I had to learn English. I sure as hell wasn't gonna do that in a neighborhood full of Italians. That's where I met Joe.
Come on, Vito, hurry it up. We ain't got all night.
Over time, Joe and I got to be best friends. And since we were both poor and there wasn't much work around, we started a little business of our own.
Freeze! Police! Stop!
Vito, this way! Throw me to bed! Stop! Run the chute!
Shit.
Okay, you bastard. Spread your legs.
Fuck.
And put your hands on the fence.
I'm sorry.
Well, that one time it didn't work out so good. The year was 1943. America was at war, and the army was looking for guys who spoke the language to help with the invasion of Sicily. I was 18, and anything seemed better than jail. Who says you can't go home again?
Chapter 1. The Old Country. Sicily, July 1943.
Operation Husky. I was assigned to the 504th Parachute Infantry. On the 11th of July, we were supposed to be dropped over the southern coast of Sicily. But we got hit by flak and had to bail out. Way behind enemy lines. Only three of us made it. If it wasn't for the local resistance, we wouldn't have had a chance. So when Mussolini soldiers came into the town and started rounding everybody up, we decided to return the favor.
Se nessuno parla, quest'uomo morirà.
Eh? No, 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 no.
Hey. Allora, traditori! Pensavate di...
Behind the sand! Oh, to run.
Shit!
Corporal, this guy's saying there's more troops headed this way.
All right. You and Williams take out that MG, then find the prisoners. We're gonna need every man we can get. Ain't getting through this way.
Looks like we found
you got a grenade.
Watch it! Put a grenade through the window!
That was a lucky shot, I ain't gonna lie.
Scaletta, you alive?
Yeah, just about.
Well, then get off your ass.
Grab all the ammo you can carry.
Yeah. Get some stuff here.
Whoa. Look at this
shit. Okay. Anything else we need? Trying to take all the guns I can. We are gonna go in, obviously, with a rifle.
On the stairs.
Okay, we're gonna use this.
Perfect. Must have the prisoners upstairs. Clear the second floor. Scaletta, you take point.
Right. Yeah, this is the definitive edition of Mafia 2. This one got a lot of hate because you'll probably see some of the problems I might go through during this playthrough. Yeah, you never know. Sometimes I get really lucky and I don't have to deal with any of them. Sometimes I don't get as lucky. Like when I played GTA 3, the Definitive Edition, you know, something that had a lot of problems. I never really had a major problem like other players did. But then again, GTA 3 wasn't, you know, one of the games that had the most problems. The game that had the most problems was San Andreas, no doubt. But yeah, we just come on and see the journey of Mafia 2 to the Definitive Edition. I'm just gonna blow them away. Blow them in. That dude saved Vito's life.
Ma chi è quello? Lo conoscete?
Lo conoscono tutti. Don Calò è un uomo d'onore.
È uno stupido trucco degli americani, non ditemi che gli credete.
No, è davvero Don Calò. Ogni tanto dovesse ascoltare i consigli di noiacci del posto. Ci rendiamo.
Sapete che potete affidarvi di me. Che ne dite, eh?
Don Calò, the head of the Sicilian mob. An entire garrison of troops surrendered that day. Why? Because he told them to.
Shows how much power the mob had back in the day. Looks like we're gonna load into another chapter. But yeah, that is kind of like the tutorial for Mafia 2. A pretty good tutorial, if you ask me. I feel like Mafia 3 should have had something like that, but it is what it is. Chapter 2, Home Sweet Home. 2 years later, Empire Bay, February 8th, 1945. Ain't that something? That's the day this video comes out.
A few years later, the Nazis put a bullet in me. I was in the hospital for a bit. Then I got a month's leave so I could go home. At least for a little while.
Over here!
Joe!
Hey! Welcome home, buddy.
How'd you know?
I got my sources. Come on, let's take a ride.
Nice car.
Comes with the territory. I know you're itching to get home, but first, let's get a beer.
Yeah, sure.
I do like the snowy atmosphere of Empire Bay in Mafia 2. Something about it I really do like. Bay.
Tell the truth, you miss it?
Hey, there's a bear shit in the woods. Not like this place ever done me any favors, but anything's better than a foxhole. What's with this shitty weather?
They're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Papers say it's gonna keep up like this for weeks. Don't worry, though, a drink will warm you right up. How long's it been since we had a drink together, Vito? 2 years?
Almost three. Tony Sicelli's party, right?
Come on, Vito, come on. The last drink we had together was right after your romance funeral. Right before you shipped out. You remember.
5 minutes, we're already talking about my deadbeat father. Can we change the subject, please?
So tell me, pal, what was it like over there anyway? I kept reading the papers to see what was going on. And you know how much I hate reading.
Yeah, I know.
You guys kicked Mussolini's ass, right?
Sort of. We had a little help from a guy named Don Calo.
No shit, Don Calo. I heard of him.
Really?
You bet. I know guys like him over here. Wise guys. You work for them, you're set. You fuck with them, you die.
Nice to see you've been busy.
Yeah, and I heard you got a medal, right?
From old man Patton himself.
Whoa, so you're a real war hero, huh? And then what? You screwed a couple of Sicilian broads and came home?
Yeah, right.
The old country. Over here, you can screw anything with a heartbeat. No one gives a shit. What a country. Here's to the U.S. of A. and to having you back home.
And that's Joe.
Salud.
Salud. Chin down. So how come you're back? They let you out early for good behavior?
Nah, I took a bullet a couple months back, spent some time in the hospital, and now I'm on leave.
Wait. You mean you gotta go back?
What'd you think? The war ain't over yet.
You don't want to go back, do you?
Nah, of course not, but what can I do?
1 minute. Wait right here.
Both mother and daughter working for the Yankee Dollar.
Hey, Giuseppe, it's Joe. Remember last week, you know, the guy's name is Vito Scaletti. Thanks, Giuseppe. All right, I'll see you later.
The situation is mighty queer, like the Yankee girl.
Okay, listen up. It appears that your injury is much more serious than it first appeared, and the doctors say you can't fight no more.
What? Oh, did you just...
Like I said, I know people. You get all the official paperwork tomorrow. When it comes to the right stamps and signatures, it's just a question of money.
You're kidding me, right? Isn't that a bit risky? It's me that could end up in a slammer, you know? And how am I gonna pay for it?
I got it covered. Think of it as a welcome home present. And don't worry, the documents will be clean. Trust me.
Well, thanks.
You're welcome. Come on, Friday, you're like a brother to me. Now you can start thinking about what you're gonna do next.
Sure. But first, I gotta go home.
All right, you wanna ride?
No, thanks. I wanna walk around a little, see what's changed since I've been gone.
No problem. Say hello to your sister for me. Come see me tomorrow. We got a lot to talk about.
I can't believe you just got me out of the service. Thanks again.
No problem.
I'll catch up with you tomorrow.
Let it snow playing. So this mission is a little different than any old mission, but this is a little different than any other. You can talk to some people. Let's see if we can talk to them.
How you doing, soldier?
Not bad now that I'm home.
You want to leave or home for good?
That's classified. So what's new around here?
Tell the truth, not much. Everybody just wants the war to be over. And they're saying this is the coldest winter on record. Wish I had some good news.
Yeah, you and me both. All right, I see.
Catch you later, buddy.
Yeah, you can just go up to random people and talk. Right here.
Vito!
It's not you. Hello, Mrs.
Vito? It is you. You look so handsome in that uniform. Your mother must be so proud. And what about poor Salvatore Montemaggiore? How's he doing? His poor mother was expecting him home a week ago.
Yeah, Sal joined the Navy. I'm in the Army. It's different.
Why don't you come inside and have some tea with me, Vito? You could tell me all about it.
Thanks, but I'm kind of in a hurry. I just got back, and I can't wait to see my mother and Frankie.
Such a pretty girl, that Francesca. It's a wonder she's not married yet. Well, say hello to your mother for me, Vito.
There's a few other people we can talk to. Can we talk to these people?
Let him go! Yeah, we'll be right back.
Forget it, you two. He's not going anywhere.
It's just one lousy beer.
Crazy broad.
That's what he said to us. Then he comes home at 3 in the morning smelling like gin and another dame's
car. Who's that girl that Vale was looking at? Maybe another person. He's over there. Talk to this guy. Nothing. Alright, we can talk to this guy over here.
Vito? Is that you?
Hey, Mr. Manon. Closing the shop?
You know, I just can't afford to stay in business.
Wow, I'm sorry.
Yeah, well, the war's not your fault, Vito. Who knows? Maybe when the war ends, I'll open up again.
Well, good luck then.
Hey, thanks, kid.
Yeah, those are the various people you can talk to, you know, while you're just roaming through the streets on your way in. Let's go see Vito's mother and sister.
Hi, Mama. I'm back.
Vito. Vito, my boy. My boy's home. I thought I'd never see you again. Francesca and me, we wait.
Hey, sis, what's going on?
We wait for you.
Yeah.
Sit down, sit down. You must be hungry, Vito. Francesca made you a special dinner. Zuppa di pollo. It's good for you.
Wow, looks good, Frankie.
It's a shame your papa didn't live to see this. He would be so proud, Vito.
Yeah, sure.
Vito, you know better.
Sorry, Mama, sorry.
Benedice, Signore, pronunciare la tua volontà. Stiamo ricevendo, provvedi nel tuo vicino di noi.
You should get some sleep. Your room is just like you left it.
So how you two been? Franny, what you been up to?
I still live here with Mama. I got a nice office job. It pays the bills, and I started paying off some of Papa's debts.
Francesca, we don't want to talk about that now.
Talk to her.
How are you, mio bambino? It must have been so terrible. I was so afraid. I prayed for you every day.
I'm okay, Ma. I drove a Jeep most of the time. Sometimes I had a fight.
I like this Jeep. Alright, let's head to Vito's room. Lights off. switch the light on. Or a light switch. Alright, let's use the bed. It just stares at the wall. The next day.
This ain't gonna cut it. I gotta find a place to stay.
Chris? We have a few options. Now, obviously, I'm just gonna go with the normal. You know, the common leather jacket and shirt.
So you have to go back soon?
Actually, looks like I won't. Joe's taking care of it for me.
Joe, you want to get into trouble again?
Mama, would you rather me go back and get shot again?
No.
Exactly.
No.
Joe probably saved my life.
Promise that you won't get in any more trouble with that Joe. You know, your papa used to work for this man at the waterfront named Papalardo. He's in the union. You could talk to him. Work hard like you were your papa. Talk to him. Please, promise me you go talk to him today.
Okay, Mama, okay, I promise.
Grazie a Dio.
Okay. Talk to her anymore? Nope. This is Joe's place. So yeah, the cutscenes in this game are really like, they look really good. Like the beginning one, when I first started the game, oh my, I don't know, just, I think it's like the nostalgia kind of hitting me because I played this game when I was young.
I don't give
I'm
a
sorry.
Damn. I don't care.
We'll get the
if you
money.
Gotta sell everything
I promise.
You got. What the hell's going on here?
Vito!
You mind your business,
no.
Asshole.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
But the cutscenes are just
on,
awesome.
I'm gonna
in this
take
game.
You to school.
Oh, tough guy. Scaring a woman, huh? Come on. Show me what you got.
Vito, please. You're making it even worse. Stop, please. Vito, what are you doing?
Take care of him.
Please, Vito, this isn't
Ooh.
Ah, fuck this. Yeah, that's right. Get the fuck out of here. You're gonna be sorry. The both of yous.
What the hell was that all about?
I'm sorry, Vito. We didn't want to bother you with this.
Bother me? Bother me with what? Come on, tell me what's going on here, Frankie.
Right before he died, Papa borrowed money. A lot of money from a loan shark, thinking he'd get a better job and pay him back. We found out right after you left for the war.
How much?
$2,000.
What? Shit.
The worst thing is, this guy wants it all back by the end of this week. Otherwise, the debt goes up again.
I ain't gonna make that kind of money working at the port. Who is this guy?
I don't know. Mama won't tell me. It's okay, Vito. We'll manage somehow.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this. I promise.
Thanks, Vito. Take care of yourself.
I gotta get my hands on $2,000 fast. I bet Joe could help me out.
That's the thing about loan sharks is that when you know, you borrow money, you know, it's like, oh, I'll get the money back, but most of the time, people can't, and they beat people that do that. Right, let's see what these people want.
Is it fixed yet?
It's the same as when you asked me 10 seconds ago.
Crying out loud.
What the hell's the matter with you now?
It's taking me forever, and I'm cold.
So sit in the damn car if you're cold.
It's cold in the car, too. Hurry up and fix this piece of junk.
It'd get done a hell of a lot quicker if you quit nagging me and give me a hand.
I am not nagging you.
Yeah, uh-huh. Well, if you were as good with a wrench as you were with your mouth, we could have this damn thing fixed already.
You are so useless. It's no wonder the army wouldn't take you.
You had to bring that up again, didn't you?
Ethel's husband, Frank, he's a fighter pilot. Margaret's husband, Charlie, he drives a submarine.
I'm warning you.
My husband? Oh, he's a 4F. He works at the grocery store.
You know what? Fix it yourself then, you lousy bitch!
Right. Repair it.
Hey, need a hand?
Sure do. Hope you're better at this thing than my good-for-nothing husband.
There we go. All done. I just needed to, screw a couple things in.
Really? Well, thank you very much, handsome.
Don't mention it.
All right, so we helped out a good deed for the day. Now we're gonna head to Joe's and see what Joe wants or what we want to get from Joe. Cross that. But no, again, I really do love the snowy atmosphere in Mafia 2. You know, just something about it is nice. You know, kind of like gives me like the feeling that. No, what am I saying? Like in GTA 4, right? I wish, you know, there was like a snowy part of the game, you know? Because I don't know, it would just make the game so much different.
Do you know where Joe Barbaro lives?
To the right of the stairs. And tell him that racket last night has to stop. If he don't like it, he can find another place to live.
But yeah. That's just my opinion about GTA 4. Not that it's relevant to Mafia 2. That's my opinion.
This is bad.
We ain't getting out at all. Come on in, let's talk.
You disgusting pig.
I picked up these broads on my way back from the store. I've been waiting for you. All right, girls, that's it for now. I got business. Stop by tomorrow, okay? We'll pick up where we left off. Chop, chop.
Come on, Joey. We make a stop and we can all have fun.
The fun's over, baby. Later, I say. Me and Vito here haven't seen each other for a long time. We got a lot of catching up to do.
Looks like you're doing okay, Joey boy.
Not bad. I tell you, that little Spanish broad is fucking wild. So how'd it go at home?
Good. Mama wasn't thrilled when I mentioned your name, though. You know how she is. She wants me to get a straight job.
You're gonna look for one?
I don't know, but I sure as hell ain't gonna make the same mistake my old man did. I gotta pay off his debts, then get back on my feet and get my own place. I need to make some real money, and punching the clock ain't gonna cut it.
Hey, you can stay with me as long as you need to, and we'll find you a job where you can make good money without killing yourself, all right?
Music to my ears. Right now, I'm living off the 20 bucks the state gives me every week.
I know lots of people who pay well for a risky job, so to speak. I'm sure I can line something up for my oldest friend. The working man's a sucker, that's for damn sure.
You said it.
Okay, step one. I gotta introduce you to Giuseppe so we can pick up them discharge papers. Let's go.
You made enough cash for all this in the last 3 years?
More like the last 3 months. I barely had time to furnish the place.
3 months? Holy shit.
You just gotta know the right people, and you're all set, because you know me. So you thought about what you're gonna do now?
You said you were gonna introduce me to that guy Giuseppe.
No. I meant, you know, the big picture. When you was over there, didn't you think about what you was gonna do when you got back?
Nah, not really. Well, besides the usual, you know. Find a nice girl, settle down.
Whoa. Hey, there's gonna be plenty of time for that shit later. Right now, I'm gonna make sure you live a little.
Hey,
Thanks again for that thing with the discharge papers.
Hey, all I did was make a phone call. You can thank Giuseppe when we go pick him up.
Hey, you think I could,
What? Drive, Vito? The roads are icy. You ain't never drove a car before.
Joe, I was driving almost the whole time I was over there.
Yeah, but this ain't no tank, Vito. This is one of the nicest cars money can buy.
I didn't drive a tank. I drove a Jeep.
What the hell's a Jeep?
It's, Never mind. You gonna let me drive or what?
All right. Here's the keys. Just be fucking careful. All right, when it's cold as fuck outside, you gotta give it a little more gas than usual. That's the pedal over there on the right.
I know, Joe, I know.
That is just like GTA.
Okay, now make a right here. Then just go straight for a while.
Now they totaled your car, Joe.
Hey, whoa, slow it down a bit. No need to get pulled over for no reason.
Have to lose your arm, bro.
Hey, Vito, you know what time it is?
It's daytime. How the fuck should I know?
It's time for you to get your own fucking car.
Yeah, I'd love to if I could afford one.
Who says you're gonna pay for it? You know, you wasn't kidding. They really taught you to drive over there. At least something good come out of it. Ooh, get a load of that baby.
Nice, that's a 42 Jefferson.
Beautiful car like that, it'd be a shame to smash the window. You should grab yourself some lockpicks over at Giuseppe's. Welcome to Giuseppe's General Store, a thief's paradise. You name it, he's got it. He even sells phony gun permits and discharge papers for guys tired of getting their asses shot off. Hey, Giuseppe, I brought
Hello,
you a
Joe.
New customer.
He's straight up, right?
Yes, sir, all the way. This here's Vito, my oldest friend. This is Giuseppe, the best safecracker in Empire
Retired,
Bay.
Please. How are you? The papers for you?
Yeah, they are. You got them finished already?
It was a pain in the ass, but sure, they're done.
Well, thanks. This really gonna work?
Nobody from the army will bother you again, trust me.
You see? What'd I tell you? Here's the money. Take your papers, Vito.
We need a set of lockpicks, too.
That we do. And guess who's paying for them?
Lockpicks, $7.
Grazie. Well, you can test it right now. Here, take this lock. You just need to insert the pick into the lock and lift all the pins. You use the wrench to hold the pins.
This is one of the things that Mafia 2 players loved.
Just turn the wrench and the lock, she opens. Easy.
These little tiny mini games.
Whoa. See you around, Giuseppe. Say Benedict.
Easy, huh?
I see you soon,
Don't worry,
Vito.
You'll get the hang of it. I do it all the time when I lock my keys in the car. Okay, you still feel like snagging that car?
You kidding me? Absolutely.
Well, here's your chance.
Perfect.
Possible stolen vehicle.
Police want to arrest you.
Step on it.
Roger that. Vehicle theft.
Luckily, I didn't go into that.
Yeah, well, it's not over yet.
That glitch.
10-4.
Yeah, glitch where it just keeps on freezing like that, slowing down. Because some players have gone through that. This vehicle is pretty nice.
All right. Looks like we lost it. So how do you like the car?
Not too bad. Think I'll keep it.
All right, let's go find ourselves a body shop. They provide the kind of services we're looking for.
Hey, that don't sound cheap.
Don't worry about it. I got it covered. Just find any body
shop.
I know the guy who runs it.
Park right here in front of the garage door. Okay, now honk your horn.
I'm gonna trick this baby out.
How can I help you?
I'm just gonna change the plates. We're gonna go for something not really original. But you'll see what I do. Bam. Vito.
There you go. Give her a couple of
repaint. We're gonna paint her black.
Are you looking for a new set of wheels?
Some new rims. I don't know. I like those. Plates. Repaint. All right.
Thanks a lot.
Look at the beauty.
All right. Next, you should introduce yourself to Mike Bruski. He probably have some work for you.
All right. Where is he?
He owns a junkyard over in Riverside. You can't miss him.
Hey. Who's that guy back there?
What guy?
The guy at the body shop.
Oh, Tommy. He's my buddy's nephew. He's kind of quiet, but let me tell you, the kid's some hell of a dancer. Saw him at the old dance hall in Oyster Bay a couple of weeks ago. He had all the broads going nuts.
Do I detect a hint of jealousy?
Are you kidding? I don't need no dance moves. I got charm, my friend. Here, I'll give you some of my lines, so maybe you won't have to spend so many nights with Rosie Palm and her five sisters. Hey, here's one. Hey, is that a mirror in your pocket? Because I can see myself in your pants. Here, I got another one. If I could rearrange the alphabet, I put you and I together.
Oh, come on.
That's real original right there.
Oh, this one never fails. Hey, baby, that's a nice outfit. It'll look good crumpled up at the foot of my bed in the morning.
And this works for you.
Oh, man.
Oh, here's a good one. Hey, do you know the difference between sex and conversation? No? You want to go back to my place and talk?
You got problems, you know that?
Oh, man, he's a character.
How about this one? Why don't we go back to my place and play house? You be the door and I'll slam you.
Oh, that was bad.
Hey, when you measure seven soft, you don't have to be good with words. You get my drift?
Oh, man.
That's Mike's junkyard there. Just drive through the gate.
Hey, look who's here.
Hey, Mikey boy, what's going on? Shit, Mike, you could wash your fucking hands once in a while. Now I need a fucking bed.
Hey, I've been working. Working people occasionally get dirty, you know? Besides, I just wiped them off.
With what? The same fucking rag you used to clean the toilet, you filthy fuck?
Put a lid on it. What are you, from the health department, or you want to do some business?
Business, of course. This here's my friend Vito. Vito, this is Mike Bruski. But don't shake his hand. I ain't got that much soap at home.
Nice to meet you, Vito.
Me and Vito go way back. He just come back from overseas and he needs some cash. So I figure he can help with your, supply problem. I can vouch for him.
Uh-huh. Okay. Joe told you about our side business, right?
Yeah.
I only want regular cars, nothing fancy. You get a cut of every car. I take as many as I can handle. And don't bring no cops around, okay? They follow you here. I don't know your ass from Jesus. You get me?
Got it.
God damn it, Mike! You put your grubby mitts on my fucking coat. I paid a fortune for this thing.
All right, calm down or I'll stick them up your ass, you sissy.
You know, dry cleaning costs these days.
Jesus Christ.
And who knows if they can even get this filled
out. You shut up. Vito, listen to me. I need a Walter coupe today. I got a few people looking for parts, but I can't find a car.
Because you don't know where to look. Every time I drive down Hunters, I see one parked by a bar there. I think the place is called the Lone Star.
Isn't that a Moulinan neighborhood? I'll stick out like a sore thumb.
All right, look, I'll give you $350 for it. It's worth the risk, right?
$400.
All right, deal.
Alfredo, come on, let's go. Andiamo.
Meantime, I'll be sending you the cleaning bill for my coat.
Yeah, I'll change my address, you rat prick.
Okay, listen up. This is your maiden voyage, so to speak. So try not to fuck it up, eh? Here, Vito, take this, just in case.
Hey, nice. Hey, Mike, you mind if I test this thing out here?
Sure. Knock yourself out. Here you go. Aim for that old wreck over there.
Alright. Hold on to the aim. Press R to the fire. Get it? How did I miss that?
Hey, you ain't a bad shot. Hey, Vito. See if you can hit the gas tank.
Ah, shit. Did I leave gas in that thing?
There's a Pollock joke there, but I'll leave it alone.
Oh, yeah, that reminds me. Fuck you.
All right, that's enough shooting. We got work to do.
Drive to the Lone Star Bar with Joe.
The way we came in and get on the main highway going west. Don't go back through the city.
Man, Mike Buski is a pretty cool character. He's not really there much in the story, but if you need money, he plays a pretty good part.
Go right up here.
Oh. Dang. All them drifts.
So how's it feel to be back?
Good. Feel a lot better with some money in my pocket.
Hey, what's the rush? Money don't buy you happiness, you know.
Get the fuck out of here.
I was just fucking with you. Don't worry about the money. This little job is just the beginning. Pretty soon you'll be rolling in it.
So, Sand Island's still the same shithole it was when I left?
No, the place actually ain't too bad now.
Oh shit. How the hell that happened?
All the moolies flew south for the winter. Of course it's still a shithole, Vito. You only been gone a couple of years. Gonna take a lot longer than that for that neighborhood to turn around. Them people multiply like rabbits. What are you gonna do? It's even worse than when we was kids. They even got some kind of gang there now. What's their fucking name? The Beamers, the Boomers, something like that. I don't fucking know.
Oh, that's just fucking great.
Hey, what are you worried about? They're animals. All they do is sell dope and kill each other. They ain't gonna bother a guy like you. And even if they do, that's why I gave you that pistol.
Oh, by the way. You're carrying a gun now? What's the deal with that?
Can't do business without it these days, especially in this fucking neighborhood.
You, really know how to inspire confidence, you know that?
Take a left up here.
This neighborhood was. You know something? One of these days, I'm gonna buy a house.
Look at this guy. Ain't even back a day and he's too good for his old neighborhood.
Hey, what are you breaking my balls for? I'm just window shopping. It'll be years before I could afford a place like this.
You got champagne taste and beer pockets, my friend. Don't worry though, I'm gonna help you change that.
Yeah, if you haven't noticed, I turned on simulated driving. It's gonna give it more of a real feel because, you know, after playing Mafia Definitive Edition, you know, kind of feels. Kind of want to keep that feel, you know what I mean? I'll slow down just in case. Cops actually pull you over in this game for speeding.
It's that cream colored baby over there. Be careful. Do it quick and get the fuck out of there. Break a window if you have to and go. I'll wait for you back at Mike's.
Hey, what if I run into problems?
Then you deal with them. Look, consider this a test. If you fail, I hear they're hiring down at the factory.
Right, just asking.
Good luck, pal. I see you back at Mike's.
You're the cream-colored Walter Q. All right. I'm over an obstacle.
Hey, what the fuck are you doing over there?
Ah, shit.
Boom. Take care of this guy real quick. Huh. is this guy?
Hey! Hey, what you doing, motherfucker?
I'll take care of these guys. Peek out, peek out. That guy, and this guy. We're gonna lockpick this. Our money. It's not really that hard to lockpick. Bam, done. Alright, so we got a problem over there. Get behind. That's over here. Alright, and there's another guy over here somewhere. We're gonna take care of these people over here too. Yeah, open the gate. Climb over the fence. Simple. I just gotta leave. Dang. Escape the bombers. Looks like the cops will deal with them. Let's wait till they're done there. There you go. Okay, who's gonna hit that? Taken care of. Alright, so now I just gotta head back to Mike's. It's gonna be a pretty long drive, so I'll see y'all at Mike's. Alright, so here we are. We're back at Mike's. About to roll up in the coupe.
Hey, mission accomplished. How'd it go?
Yeah, piece of cake. Except for the fact that the car belonged to a bunch of moolies who immediately tried to kill me right after you left.
Probably the bombers. Hunters their neighborhood. Guys like that, you don't have to worry about them. They just hang out on the street, talk shit, steal shit, and smoke dope. Let's see what we got here.
Nice. No stains. Clean.
The lowlife get the money for this. Probably stole it himself. It's nice, though. How much did I say I'd give you for it again?
600.
Oh, I like your buddy, Joe. Here's your 400 bucks. Stop by again, okay? We can do some more business.
Yeah, you bet, Mike.
I see you, Mike. I'll stop by again real soon.
All right, boys. I'll see you later.
Here's your 300 bananas. I'm taking my cut as the middleman. Next time, you're on your own.
All right. Thanks, Joe.
All right, let's go home. I'm exhausted.
Go back to Joe's.
You should take the highway, Vito.
This chapter wasn't too bad. Getting into the swing of things.
Yeah, but I almost got my ass kicked. I didn't live through the war just to die in Sand Island.
Hey, that's all part of the deal, pal. Take it or leave it. Besides, it ain't like you're qualified for anything else.
I guess you're right.
Don't worry about it. It's all gonna be a piece of cake.
So, what's the story with Brewski?
Mike's a good guy to know. He's a little grouchy, but he's always got a scam going. He deals with stolen cars mostly. Spent some time inside a while back. I heard he used to stick up gas stations back in the day.
You gonna make him pay the cleaning bill for your jacket?
Nah, I'll let that one slide. I do a lot of business with the guy. Plus, he's got one hell of a temper. One time we was at the track and some mitt spilled a beer on his wind ticket. Mike beat the shit out of him till he went blind in one eye. For a lousy $10, you believe that shit?
Sounds like kind of a scumbag.
Hey, you just gotta know how to handle these people. And Mike's a pussycat compared to some of the guys I met since you shipped out. You'll see.
Yes, we will.
Hey, is there a safe place to park around here? I don't want to leave this thing out in the street.
Yeah, that's why you're parking your car next to mine in the garage. The streets are full of criminals these days.
Yeah, the neighborhood ain't what it used to be, huh?
That car's full of them, too. Go to Joe's apartment. Better run.
If you're hungry, there's some food in the refrigerator.
Open the fridge and take some food.
Take whatever you want from the fridge.
Have ourselves a sandwich. Crash on the kitchen couch to get some sleep. All right. And I think that's it for chapter 2. And that's where I'm going to leave off. We'll start on chapter 3. Let me get this thing off out of the way first. Alright, so probably before I go to sleep at the end of every chapter, I'll probably just end off the video. I thought I could pause it before, but whatever. Anyways guys, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know I've been gone for a very long time. It's been 2 or 3 weeks now. I just can't wait to get more videos out to you guys. I'm back and I'm excited to do Mafia 2. I've played Mafia 2 pretty much my whole life. For a very long time, and it's just a game I've always wanted to play for you guys, but never really had the chance to. And I want to branch out and do more games, you know, other than GTA, because I've noticed I've been in a kind of like GTA trap this past year, you know, GTA 5, GTA Vice City, GTA 3, you know, just so many games. GTA, you know, but I want to expand more and do other series. So Mafia 2 is one of the first, you know, I mean, obviously I've had Call of Duty and Watch Dogs and stuff like that, but you know what I mean. Anyway guys, before I leave, I want you guys to hit the subscribe button, hit that like button, share this video, all your friends, so you guys enjoy this video more in the future. Anyways, I will see you guys in the next video. Take care now.